Hi guys, so what we want to do now is have a look at how we download data from the semiotic automatic classification plugin. Once you installed it, and you can do it through the plugins manager here, you have this ribbon here, you have the SCP item menu item. And we want to download products, so we activate the download product interface. But before we start doing it, let's have a look at this. And as you can see, this plugin is not only about downloading products, it does the whole image analysis process. But that's not what we are going to do today. So, first, as you know, our products are satellite images. And those satellite images, you need an interface to download it. They were photographed and sometimes analyzed to some level by, I don't know, the European Space Agency. And in order to get the data, you must have a username and password in their website. So to get such credentials, just click on the links. If I click this link, I get into the proper website. I already have a username, but you can create a profile and put in here your credentials. We're working with Sentinel data, so if I remember correctly, the European Space Agency is what we need, but maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's the American USGS, Geological Survey, or NASA. I don't know. I don't really remember. But once we completed the credentials, we can go to the search interface. And if I click this and this, I can go. This is the show on map. This is the open street map. I can go here. You can see that my mouse pointer is now a cross. And using this cross, I click using the left click on the left upper corner. And using the right click on the bottom right corner of the region I'm interested in. Once I did that, the coordinates are transferred here. Other things I think you should limit is the maximum cloud cover. I think if you want to be able to do max something with your image, it has to be at least 70% clear, so 30% cover is the maximum. And a date range. In my case, I want a fall image, so I take it from the 1st of October, of September, to the, let's say, 10th of November. And I'm selecting Sentinel-2 images, up to 20 results, and I can do the search. Every time you search, you fill in this table here. And you add more lines. Every time you search, you will add more lines. Meaning if I'm searching again now, the result of the search will be added here. The way you manage this table is using these buttons here. And you can preview the images. This is not really my region. It touches it, but it's not really my region. This one is not my region. This one is more like my region, and you carry on doing it for the whole table, but for now we know that the first and second images aren't interesting. I removed all of the lines by instance. So again, I search again. And again. This one is not interesting. This one is not interesting. This one is. So I choose those two lines and remove them. Not interesting. Not interesting. Not my region. Not my region. Okay, so out of this set of images, I opted for this one. Now I have to define the download options. And I don't need this one, only if preview in layers. I don't need it because I've already previewed my images here. You could do the pre-process, which you'll have to define here. That's the Sentinel-2 pre-process. Back to download. And I want it to be loaded to QGIS. And before I run it, I have to define the download options, which are basically which bands to download. The image is produced in many bands, many wavelengths, and you could download all of them and you could download some of them. I'm doing NDVI, so I only need those two, 3 and 8. And how do I know it? Because NDVI uses the near infrared and the green colors. And if I type in Google Sentinel-2 bands, I'm getting the list of the bands. So, having explained all of that, I can just run it. It's gonna take some time. The download is gonna take some time. I select the folder. Once the download is complete, this is not gray anymore. I can go to the canvas and see my downloaded product. And if I want to know which is which, I can go to properties and I see this is the 8th band near infrared, and this is the 3rd band green, and I'll carry on from that. But we're done. We've downloaded data using the semi-automatic classification plugin.